It's 16 months since Station Officer Colin Townsley died a hero, and today there was anger in the High Court, but it's taken so long for compensation for his family to be settled. Mr. Townsley gave his life trying to guide passengers to safety from the fume-filled booking hall at King's Cross Station. He left a widow, Linda, and two daughters. A year on, his parents proudly received his posthumous commendation for bravery, but even then the compensation issue remained uncertain. At a public inquiry, London Underground was criticised for overlooking safety, but solicitors representing Mr. Townsley's widow Linda said the company refused initially to accept liability, and this was blamed for the delay in the compensation case. Today's settlement of £250,000 was finally agreed out of court and confirmed by a judge.
It's a satisfactory settlement. I only wish that it could have been made many months ago. You heard in court that the defendants had been given details of the claim some time ago. I think Mrs. Townsley has suffered an awful lot of distress which could have been avoided by an earlier settlement. I'm pleased that the case has now finally concluded, and so is Mrs. Townsley. I hope she can now put all this behind her and to get on trying to rebuild her life after the tragic loss of her husband.
For the first time, this settlement includes unique compensation for what's been described as pre-impact terror. The court heard that Mr. Townsley undoubtedly knew in the last moments that he was likely to die, and some of the compensation is to acknowledge that terror. In court, London Underground blamed the delay on the family's solicitor for failing to provide information. It was a charge hotly refuted. More than 100 other compensation claims have been filed with London Regional Transport, and many people were closely watching today's case.
A lot of people are very confused. Some people are getting very high solicitors' bills that they don't know what to account for, how to account for. And, you know, it's been a year and 4 months, and not many people have had anything at all yet.
London Underground say the remaining claims for compensation will be handled as quickly as possible. This is Teresa Driscoll for Thames News.